Good day. In this video presentation, we will be speaking with Dr. Paulo Totaro of Federal University of Alagoas in Brazil about the article Biological Recursion and Digital Systems, written by himself and jointly Dr. Domenico Nino from the University of Naples in Italy. The full article will be published by Theory, Culture and Society magazine. Hello, Paulo. What is the issue of the article?
Good day, Anna. So we have a common element between the biological systems and the machine. This element is recursion. On the one hand, the theory of recursive function has established the equivalence between the set of algorithms and the set of recursive functions. On the other hand, neuroscience converges on theories that put recursion at the center of biological and cognitive processes. Recursion seems therefore to be the thread that unites man and machines and makes machines understandable and useful for man. Can this common bond weaken over time and make machine behavior less understandable and useful? This article argues it can happen and indicates the conditions of this occurrence.
What is a recursive process?
Recursive process consists of applying an operator to its own results. Let's take the example of a natural number, which are generated in a recursive way. Starting from number zero, number one is given by the success of zero. Number two is given by the successor of one, that is, by the successor or successor of zero. And so on for the number three, number four, etc., etc. Thus, the recursion is a generative process. At each step, the result is generated by applying the same operation to its result from the previous step.
What does the article propose about relationship between recursion, man and machines?
The results of recursion stem from a generative process. However, once they are generated, we can also consider them disconnected from the process. For example, number three can be considered as a successor of two, or as a set of three things. Technically, it is said that in the first case, the number is considered in an ordinal way, while in the second, it is considered in a cardinal way. Biological recursion works ordinally. Consequently, even when we consider results of biological recursion in a cardinal way, we can always trace them back to their generative and sequential order, and therefore understand them. Diversely, digital recursion does not work ordinally, but cardinally. The logical blocks that make a calculator consist of preordained combinations of zero and one. We understand these predetermined combinations of one and zero as arithmetic and logical operations because we trace it back to the order of biological recursion. When this translation is difficult or impossible, the informative meaning of these combinations becomes ambiguous and therefore either difficult to understand or easily manipulated for economic and political advantage. At this point, the usefulness of this information offered by machines becomes doubtful.
Thank you very much, Dr. Paulo Totaro.
Thanks, Anna.